Hey guys, it's Melanie. Guess what? The day is finally here. It's a beautiful sunny spring day, and I am finally able to get out into the backyard to show you guys how I customize my Homeworxx candle pedestals. I hope that Harry doesn't take offense to this. It's not meant to be offensive in any kind of way. I think it's just more of a personal preference or personal taste type thing. I am very picky when it comes to my home decor, especially the colors of the accent pieces that I bring in. I have some strong preferences when it comes to that. So for me, I have found that customizing my Homeworxx candle pedestals has been really the best option for me. I am going to show you the most simple way to do this and my own personal preference when it comes to a look. You can get a lot more intricate with this, and you can actually go and grab some paint brushes and some acrylic paint and really get in there and color each one of these flowers individually. I don't have time for that. I am a busy working mom, and normally when I'm doing a craft project, it needs to be efficient and it needs to turn out the way that I want it to look. So for me, using spray paint is the best option. And so many of you have told me that you are so intimidated about doing this to your candle pedestals. And I am here to tell you this is the easiest thing that you will ever do in your life. Really, the only thing that you need to keep in mind when doing this is light layers. And I'm gonna link some supplies in the description box that are really gonna make this much more efficient, much easier, and are really going to help to get you the results that you're actually looking for. So, some of the things that I'm going to be putting in the description box are a Lazy Susan, super helpful when you have a round object that you are trying to spray paint, or an object really of any shape or size. Get yourself a Lazy Susan. I will link my favorite one down below. I am a florist and I use Lazy Susans in my floral design all the time. So they're just a part of my like everyday work stuff collection. Super handy. I also suggest having some either craft paper or something on hand to protect your surfaces. I'm going to be showing you guys how to do this in the demonstration in our backyard. I'm hoping that it's not windy outside. It's kind of a nice summery spring day. I mean, sunny spring day. So hopefully there isn't a bunch of wind just spraying the spray paint back in my face. But yeah, I will also link my favorite brand of spray paint and my favorite colors because I'm about to show you guys some three other color options that I have used on some of my other pedestals that I think are absolute perfection, at least in terms of what fits into my home decor. Obviously, if you have red accents in your home, you could spray paint this red. I don't think it would really look good red, but don't let me hold you back. There's really, I mean, an unending number of colors of spray paint to choose from, right? Like when I go to the flower market to pick up my flowers, I literally have an entire wall of spray paint to choose from. So, yeah, my favorite brand, by the way, is the Design Master. If you haven't tried that particular brand, I think it's much better than some of the other brands that I've used in the past in terms of spray paint. But yeah, so this is obviously the floral candle pedestal. This is currently available, actually. So I will link it down below. Fair warning, it is paired with a candle. I know that is a little bit of an annoyance for some of you who just want the pedestal. I don't mind the pairings, but I mean, I get it. If you're just looking for a pedestal and you don't need another candle, it's a little bit obnoxious. But yeah, so if you want this particular pedestal, it is available. I will also link it in the description box down below. And I'm going to show you what it looks like when you get it because I have the one that we're going to be spray painting. So I'm going to move this over to the side. By the way, Coastal Water Lily, mwah, chef's kiss. Absolutely beautiful. Love it. So let's move you off to the side and let's move in the before. So this is what the pedestal will look like when you get it. It is in kind of this like tarnished silver or like aged silver coloring. I think it's pretty originally. I almost kept this one as is, but then I thought, no. I do already have a lot of silver accents in my house, and I'm kind of getting over silver, to be honest. I'm moving in more of like the warm golds and whites, creams, that kind of direction. So this really isn't a good fit for my home decor right now. So but the good thing is, if I decide that I ever want to like make this silver again, guess what? There's silver spray paint. And there's several different shades of silver to choose from. So anyway, yeah, don't have any regrets about doing this, because you can just spray paint it another color. So obviously having it go back to the original is going to be extremely difficult. In fact, probably impossible. But you know, make sure that you are okay with making a somewhat semi-permanent change to this object, and knowing that it will never return to the original color here. So anyway, this is the original. I'm going to show you guys that I also did this in an oil rubbed bronze, which I love. I do admit, I don't think the oil rubbed bronze will be for everybody. I think, quite frankly, the white is probably one of the best options for this particular pedestal. But I also, this one used to be a champagne gold, and I'll show you the champagne gold here in a second. Because I have one of my holiday pedestals in the champagne gold to show you. So I really love this oil rubbed bronze. It's got a really nice kind of shiny finish to it, and I just thought it was so elegant. This is the one that I have in my family room. Again, super easy to do this. I literally just spray painted over the champagne gold. Not a big deal. All right, speaking of champagne gold, here is that one. I love this because it has a really nice satin finish. I will be linking this one in the description box down below. Not this pedestal, but the spray paint that I used here. So if you like this, there you go. I find that the gold that Harry tends to use on his pedestals is a little too like gaudy gold for me. I think I prefer more of like a subdued satiny gold, such as this champagne gold here. This pedestal was obviously from a holiday collection. You can see there's little holly berries. This one, I could certainly go and get maybe some red acrylic paint and paint these little berries, and that would be very cute. But you know what? I like it in this kind of one tone gold look, so that works for me. Next, I'm going to show you a rose gold option. Again, I will link the rose gold spray paint down below. And this one was super fun because I also sprayed it with a shimmer spray. It's not coming off on camera, but you can see it in real life. So I spray painted the rose gold and then went over when it was dry with just a shimmer spray. And I love the way this looks. I use my pine cone pedestals around both typically the fall and like holiday season. So half the year I am pine cone girl, the other half the year I am floral girl. So this particular pedestal is not available anymore, but there are some pine cone pedestals that are available on the Homeworxx website. I will link them down below. I have not touched either of those because I actually really like the way that they look just on their own. So yeah, those were the first pedestals that I've ever picked up from Homeworxx that I've been like, okay, these just need to stay the way that they are because they're kind of perfection, especially the rose gold. Ooh, it's so beautiful and shiny. So there you guys go. There's just a little preview of some of the different options for spray paint colors that really appeal to me. But let's head out to my backyard and let me show you how easy it is to spray paint these things. You should not be intimidated by this process. I feel like it's probably one of the easiest craft projects that you can never take on. So let's head out. All right, guys, welcome to my backyard. You are currently on the construction project that is our outdoor kitchen. The granite has not been installed on it, so I'm okay spray painting on this. However, if you want to protect your surfaces, please protect them. I just actually cut some craft paper to go over my Lazy Susan. And if you don't know what a Lazy Susan is, it's one of these like turntable thingamajiggers. So this one is quite large because I use it for my floral designs. Yeah, I will link one that is 11 inches across because I think that that is just fine. So you can see why the Lazy Susan would be helpful, because it's going to help you get to the different sides without having to like turn it and touch it when it's wet. When we do this, light layers are going to be key. So I'm going to go ahead and do the first layer right now. Shake that spray paint. Really, really shake it up. And then, so by the way, this is what I'm using, the Design Master Color Tool Spray in flat white. You could certainly also get a shiny white if you want to. And you are literally just going to start lightly spraying, turning, spraying, turning, spraying. I like to do the top. And then you're gonna let that first layer dry. So we're gonna let that dry. We'll be back in a few minutes. All right. Hey friends, we're back. I fast forwarded just a little bit and did the second coat off camera, just like the first. And now I'm gonna show you guys the last coat. So typically I find that three coats of spray paint is more than enough. I was also going to mention, if you're interested in kind of giving this a slightly more rustic or aged look, you can take some really fine grit sandpaper and rub it on maybe like the edge of some of these petals here and there, and that silver will shine through, and that also is a really neat look. I like it more white, so I'm gonna leave it, but if you're interested in that, you can certainly do that as well. So I'm gonna shake up my can of spray paint, do the last coat, and then we're all done. There's some areas where you notice that there's a little bit of silver that is kind of underneath one of the petals. You can certainly just do like a quick shot in there to get that better coverage that you need. Just don't be heavy-handed. Really, that's the key to success here. Don't go in here and just like, you know, like keep the Lazy Susan moving and use light coats. That's really what you're looking for here. There we go. All right, hopefully I can get you guys a better close up here. So this is what it looks like when it's all done. So I'm just gonna need to let this dry for about, I like to leave it out for about an hour, and that's it. You guys, this is so easy. You can totally do this. This isn't complicated. Light coats is key here. Again, don't go in there and just hold it about maybe six inches away, and short little bursts, you're good. This is really hard to mess up, I promise you. All right, you guys, I hope that was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions. Take care.